fire stuff. Number one, do you think entrepreneurship is for everybody?
No.
And why?
I don't. I think you have to be, I'd say the key mindset is the ability to take risk and be comfortable with taking risk. Mm-hmm. A lot of people, I find that the difference between doing it and not doing it is a lot of time it comes down to risk. When you do something, there are so many unknowns, you have to be comfortable with that. Mm-hmm. And you have to be comfortable with the fact that there's a really high probability that you're gonna fail.
Yeah.
Most people just aren't comfortable. Like thinking about, imagine this, somebody comes to you and says, listen, I want you to absolutely dedicate your entire life, kill yourself, give up family, friends, everything. Mm-hmm. And yeah, there's a good chance it's not gonna work. It's like, that's a tough sell.
Yeah.
That's a tough sell for most people.
Do you think
it's the combination of both? You have to do both though. You have to go all in and you have to like just like work, outwork, you know,
everybody. Well, the reason I ask you that is I was reading some stuff you've said about the all in thing. So you led right where I wanted to go.
Okay.
And you had a business you had invested in where the people looking at it were like, well, why is there $390,000 of your money in this investment or in this business? Like, why is that the number, right?
Yeah.
And I thought it's genius what you're going to share here. So what did you tell them and why did that really matter at the time? Why
does that matter? And I funny, and I'll have a follow-up to that too. So yeah, so the pit.com, which is the business that I quit the banking to go do, which was a sports stock market that I sold to Topps, the baseball card company. You know, I invested on the cap table $390,000, which I had saved from banking over those years. And they said, you know, why $390,000 to invest? Why didn't you just invest $400,000? And I said, because I only have $390,000. I literally took the entire bank balance that I had saved over those 7 years, $390,000 in cash after tax, and I just, boom, put that into the business. Mm. And the one was, you know, needed some extra capital, so that was kind of good. But the primary reason was one, to show people how serious and dedicated I was, like investors, which worked, by the way.
Yep.
You don't get 60 angel investors to put 80 grand in for somebody who's never done a startup before unless they truly believe that this person's gonna do whatever it takes. Mm-hmm. And I think that was the signal. It was like, yeah, he's got every penny of money he's made into it. And then also for me, knowing that I had every penny into it was like, there's no turning back. It was life or death. I put myself in a situation where I could not fail.
Yeah.
Just couldn't fail.